Hey, what's up, guys? So this video is going to be a little bit different than my previous videos. And the reason for this is that as my channel continues to grow and as more and more people begin to kind of filter into my channel and watch the content, I think it's super important that you guys kind of get at least like a glimpse of my own personal nutrition philosophy. A lot of you guys have been commenting lately, and it has become increasingly clear that when I do disagree with you guys, it's largely because we simply have just differing approaches to nutrition. I take a very strict natural approach to my personal nutrition and health. And if you guys have not made a similar decision, we are naturally going to come to different conclusions as to what is best in order to address specific health outcomes. Now, a simple example of this would be something like TRT, which obviously increases testosterone, is going to increase muscle mass, is going to improve just the general sense of well-being. However, for individuals like myself that have previously made the decision to stay completely natural, TRT just simply isn't an option. And therefore, I have to take a somewhat more nuanced approach to increasing testosterone and improving the health markers that come along with increasing testosterone. However, it takes a lot more work and a lot more diligence in order to find these compounds and then implement them into our lives. Now, a lot of you guys are probably asking yourself at this point, Zach, why are you so opposed to synthetic hormone use and synthetic drug use? And so what I'm going to do for a little bit of this video is just simply share my story and kind of let you guys into my thinking process as to why I'm so adamant about remaining natural. Now, something that a lot of you guys know that a lot of you may also not know, I do have some previous experience with some anabolic agents. You know, I grew up somewhat of an active and athletic kid, and even into college was one of the fairly stronger individuals kind of in the circles that I was running in at the time. And towards the latter part, or actually the beginning part of my junior year of college, about 8-9 years ago, I decided to push the envelope a little bit. I wanted to kind of figure out what my body was capable of doing, how strong I could get, how big I could get. And this is when I decided that hopping on a cycle of anabolic steroids would be a good idea. Not so much. So between my junior and senior year of college, I did partially two cycles of methosterone, which is a extremely anabolic oral prohormone, and the results were honestly crazy. Like, I got extremely big, extremely strong, extremely quick, and I followed up my first 8-week cycle with a second 8-week cycle roughly like 9 months after my first cycle. And it was during this second cycle of methosterone that I really started to experience some major side effects. And the first major side effect that popped up was just signs of severe liver toxicity. And this is partially to do with just the compounds that I was taking at the time. They were methylated compounds, which is extremely difficult on the liver. And so I was essentially just destroying my liver, and I didn't even know I was doing it. And then the second major side effect that I began to experience when I was on cycle was some pretty moderate prolactogenic gynecomastia. And it actually got to the point towards the end of that cycle, roughly around week 6, I essentially decided to end my cycle early. And this is when things actually got really bad. So I ended my cycle, started my post-cycle therapy, and it took months to just simply recover some type of sense of well-being and normalcy. And even months after my cycle was over, I was still struggling with just this general sense of just depression, and just life sucked. And it was at this point in my life where I kind of had a extremely major decision to make. Do I go to my doctor and have him test my testosterone levels and hop on TRT for the rest of my life, or stick this thing out as long as possible and just try to regain as much testicular function as possible? And I chose the latter. And so what I want to do in the rest of this video is outline all of the reasonings as to why I decided to remain natural. And so let's go ahead and just quickly run through these. I made an entire post that you guys can find on the community tab of my channel. However, I didn't think it would be relevant to at least kind of run through these super quick. Now, the first reason that I decided to remain natural after my first two cycles is that needing drugs to feel normal sucks. And so for any of you guys that have ever struggled with any type of substance abuse in your past or even currently struggling with substance abuse, you'll definitely resonate with this. Waking up and feeling like you need something just to feel normal is an absolutely crappy feeling. And I wanted to avoid that at all costs. Now, the second reason I decided to remain natural after those first two cycles is just simply the risk of infertility. And this is something that's really not talked about a lot, especially by doctors and people that are proponents of TRT. You know, infertility is a very real risk with TRT. My wife and I are currently still having children, and it's my personal kind of philosophical belief that having and rearing children is actually one of like the greatest privileges that we have as human beings. That was just something that I wasn't willing to sacrifice in the name of having normal testosterone levels. Now, the third reason that I decided to remain natural is that TRT is a lifelong commitment. Now, I do think this gets massively underplayed by proponents of TRT. Taking TRT is literally a lifelong commitment. And for me, it was extremely difficult to evaluate whether or not I would want to be on TRT when I'm 50 or 60 or 80. And because it was so difficult for me to make that decision for my future self, I just perceived TRT as a massive risk, which actually kind of leads me into the fourth reason that I decided to not take TRT, which is my just complete distrust of the medical industry. Now, I've got a degree in clinical nutrition. My wife has a degree in nursing. And so both of us have seen firsthand just how dark the crevices of the medical industry are. And TRT might be readily available now, but what happens when some medical board 20 years down the road decides to make it illegal because they deem it unsafe? And this may not seem like a reasonable fear to some of you guys. However, with a government that we currently have that is increasingly seeing it as their responsibility to make my medical decisions for me, I just don't want any part of that. I don't want to link myself up with and become completely and utterly dependent on a system that is utterly broken. That's just not something that I think is a smart move for me personally. Now, the next reason that I decided to forego testosterone replacement therapy is because it is entirely possible that testosterone is supposed to decrease as we age. You know, less testosterone as men age means that we are more cooperative, we are less competitive, and it is entirely possible that testosterone is supposed to be super high during adolescence in order to promote risk-taking behavior and mate-seeking behavior, and then is supposed to decline as men move into more cooperative roles in society and establish their own family. Now, the last reason that I decided to forego TRT treatment is because I just wanted to avoid the cycle of taking drugs and then having to take more drugs to counteract the side effects of the first drug that I decided to take. It's super common practice for men to go on TRT and then immediately have to go on tamoxifen to counteract high estrogen levels, and then have to go on finasteride to counteract high DHT levels, and then have to go on Clomid in order to improve fertility, and then have to go on HCG when the Clomid doesn't work. And so there's this whole cycle of taking a synthetic hormone and then having to take other synthetic drugs to counteract the negative effects of that synthetic hormone that you're injecting into yourself twice a week. And so this was just not a train that I was willing to get on in my 20s. Now, to be clear, I do have the utmost respect for individuals that do decide to go on TRT. It's an extremely difficult decision. And for some individuals, going on TRT might be the best decision. However, I did want to be diligent to kind of just present this information to you guys and kind of just give you a glimpse into how I think and why I'm natural and why I'm so dedicated to finding the most potent and most proven natural compounds in order to improve just general well-being and health. But anyways, guys, that's pretty much all I wanted to say in this video. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave a comment down below. I'll try my best to get back to you guys as much as possible. But other than that, I'll see you next time.